Hi. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
So I'm Nadav Moskovitch from Google. Another one from Google. Sorry about that. And I look after our partnership programs in emerging markets with everything related to analytics and, of course, South Africa, Sub-Saharan Africa as well, one of those regions that I work in. Jellyfish is one of our top partners actually globally as well as locally here on the analytics side. And they asked me to come in today and talk to you a little bit about kind of machine learning, artificial intelligence, from kind of my standpoint of view. I thought that's pretty fantastic because most people want me to already shut up about it. Because I don't know if you've been into Google conferences, but that's all we're talking about for the past 2 years. But seriously, this is really kind of our main focus and our main bet in the company. And to kind of give a little bit context over that, I think that we believe in Google that every kind of 10-year decade or so, we see like a big revolution, a big shift in the technology world, something big so that changed the way we do things, changed the way we live. I think if it's in the mid-80s, it was the personal computers, right? The internet in the mid-90s. And then what's in the mid-2000s? Yeah, mobile. So all of these shifts really changed the way we interact with each other, how we access information. It's a big change how we work, right? And we believe in Google, and Lorraine before talked about it as well, that we are now kind of in the working towards kind of the artificial intelligence kind of revolution, and we really bet everything within the company on that. One of the good examples of kind of machine learning, one of our projects that started with in machine learning was actually teaching kind of the computer to play Atari games. You know Breakout, of course. And one of the things is, like, back in, if you wanted to code a computer in the old way of how to play a game, you have to teach them, you have to code in the rules. You have to put all these thousands or hundreds of thousands of conditions. If this happens, you do that. If that happens, you do this. With machine learning, with our system, we started off, you just tell them the objective, which is to maximize the score, right? And you just let them play hundreds of times, thousands of times, and see what happens. So let me show you an example. So after 100 games, it sucks. It's okay. But what happened is, what was interesting, that after 500 games, it started to build like strategies that are very similar that what we do as humans, right? Everybody knows that strategy, right? We didn't teach the computer how to do that. So that was really super interesting, we thought. And let me see if this works. Ah, no. Here we go. And of course, like Lorraine showed you before, we're using kind of this machine learning technology. We started to use it a couple of years ago in our products. So we're shifting the infrastructure of all the products that we can and putting kind of machine learning engine underneath it. One example, and I'll show you only one for now, is Google Photos. Lorraine talked about it a little bit before. Are there people here who uses Google Photos? Most of you. Those that do not, shame. But because of you, I'll get to kind of play my favorite kind of Google movie for our product. That's my favorite one. Hope you're going to like it.
Your great-grandfather was a great man. Achieved many great things and took two pictures in his life. Army, wedding. Army, wedding. You just took 36 identical photos of a sunset you thought was pretty. Your parents kept all their photos in an album. If their house caught on fire, all they'd have to do is grab the album and boom, memories saved forever. But we leave all our photos on our phone. And then leave our phone on this flight to Baltimore. Bye, photos. If by luck you haven't lost or broken your phone, chances are you have 20,000 photos taking up all your space.
What's my
You've got group selfies, self-selfies, selfies of people taking selfies, chats, caps, accidental flash, the inside of your pocket, photos of drinks, food you wished you cooked, food you actually cooked, big moments, small moments, Wi-Fi routers with really complicated passwords on them because you forgot how to change it to something you'd actually remember. If your great-grandfather wanted to show someone a photo of his wedding, he wouldn't have a tough time finding it. But if you want to show off that photo of you at your friend's wedding, good luck scrolling. Wouldn't it be great if you could find any of your photos by searching what's in the photo? If every photo you've ever taken was safely backed up online for free, so they didn't take up all the space on your phone? You know, something for the way we actually use photos. Today.
Okay. Yes, I told you it's my favorite video. If you guys used like 2 years ago Google Photos, I don't know if you noticed they just introduced machine learning engine into it. And there's some controversial stuff when people were looking for things. It kind of sucked in the beginning, but as with the Atari game, slowly it started to learn. And now it's just extraordinary. It's just getting better and better. This is just stuff I took from my phone. For example, if you want to look for bicycles, find your kids when they're riding their bicycle, or horses if you did a horse trip, parks, etc. It knows to differentiate that. Snow, of course. Concerts, by the way, you can search with things within videos. So, because videos is just like a combination, right? A lot of pictures, it knows to search within that. So if you look at concerts or anything else, this is actually something that was cool for me because like even if you don't have a geolocation from your phone, it could still identify by a lot of parameters. It has the whole internet, right, to look into all the time. So it can look, you can tell where you are anyway. You know, and then you can use combinations in Costa Rica, on the beach, find all these photos, etc. This is, I'd like to think, my invention. I tell everybody in the office that I came up with that. Just please don't dispute it. But you know how you have these brainstorming sessions, all the team in a room, in a conference room, and you put on the whiteboard, and then after a month you have to put the presentation. You don't know where the picture is that you took of the... So, ta-da. This is something that happened to me a few months ago. So my mom called me that she forgot to activate that parking meter thing, and there's an app for that. So she'll do it for me. It's like, what's the number of the license plate? She's like, I don't know. I'm not in the car already. I'm going to get a ticket if you don't do it. So I just looked. I know her car is from this brand, Kia. So I looked for it, and then I found like a picture of my daughter, and this is the car right here, and I zoomed in, and I managed. And it just kind of blew my mind how cool this is. And you signed the video before, like people take pictures of their routers, their credit cards, the stuff, crazy stuff, just to kind of not lose it. And I think... a lot of research shows like almost all of the data is like that. It's unstructured data, right? Emails, log files, your projects, all that stuff, photos, all that stuff is unstructured data. And all of the businesses, including Google, are finding this very difficult to make sense of all that stuff. Like humans were not able to solve this issue. It's just too complicated. And Lorraine showed that slide before. We are in a, this is kind of why this is our biggest bet for, and it's going to shift the way we're going to look as a company in the next 10 years because we have this, more than 1 billion monthly users on all of these 7 products right now. So how much unstructured data do we have? And like with the photos example or the transit example that you saw from Lorraine before, how much can we improve our products by really leveraging machine learning? So this is why it's our biggest bet. And we're kind of really, really scaling up on kind of switching our infrastructure to kind of be based on machine learning engines. Now, I manage the partnerships on the analytics side, so this is kind of more of my area. What I thought of doing is showing you how we're kind of moving now from photos and translating all that stuff to machine learning engines on analytic products. I know that not all of you are analysts, etc., but I want to show you kind of a live demo. Instead of kind of listing the features of what we have machine learning with, to actually show you how it looks like and what it can do. So hopefully you'll be easy on me if it fails a few times because it's a live demo, taking a risk here. So let's do that. Just 30 seconds on, this is kind of the Google Analytics suite that Google provides. Okay, so there's every product here. I'm not going to go, that's not the purpose of this presentation, but every product has a free version and kind of a paid kind of enterprise version. And I'm just going to show you a few products and some new kind of stuff that's happening on the machine learning side. Analytics and Analytics 360 is really the core of everything. This is how you measure all your kind of online activity, right? And what I show you here, it's something that just came out, and this is also on the free version. And it's called, oh, by the way, what I'm showing you right now is actually the actual analytics account of the Google merchandise store. This is the live account. You know, selling those hats with the Google logo, and the this is how we make all our money, really. So, yeah, and I'm telling you that 12 of them are doing demos like this right now. Just to be honest. So, supposed to be a serious presentation, guys. This is analytics. My manager is gonna. Okay, guys, don't. So this is the button. It's completely new. You see it over here? Intelligence. It's on the free product as well. It's now 100% all the users have it. And what's cool about it, this is a machine learning natural search engine that lets you just search with natural language. You don't have to use kind of analytics, clicks, what's the bounce rate and all that stuff. You don't have to create reports. You just ask in natural language. Very basic stuff. Let's do it together right now and see if we can get with something. Let's see, how many unique users from India on mobile in 2017? So it's a very simple kind of question for a marketer, and you just get a very simple answer, right? You don't need to create like crazy reports right now. So what we want to do is kind of make it accessible to everyone. You have to be an analyst to get this stuff. And of course, if you do want to dig deeper and you don't want to do it through the search, you can go to the report. I wouldn't know how to make to create this report, by the way. I mean, this is so easy. Let's just try something else. What is the percent of organic search to my site over time? So analytics will see, hopefully, that I'm not looking at one point, but as like over time, and it will just give me the trend, because you recognize the over time statement, and then I can see all the points within that trend. And of course, I can kind of go to the report and see the whole thing. We can go at this all day, but I prefer to just go back to your office. Everybody can use it. Just log in, click on the analytics thing. This was not possible before. That's why we didn't do it without machine learning. The more you use it and the more it learns the account, it knows to proactively suggest stuff. What do I mean? It's another feature here. This is very cool. It has a really bad name. I'm going to tell you the name, but just forget it after I tell you. They're probably going to change it. It's really new. It's called Anomaly Alerts. And what you see here is this is proactively, it learns you, learns the system, and provides you with either recommendation or with issues that you might have with your online accounts. So for example here, referral traffic is performing above average. You might want to click in, see the details, identify which referral tracker they're talking about, and then, I don't know, put more media, more money in it, call the guys, create a partnership with them. This is something you not necessarily notice by yourself. Let's look at the session quality score of some of the channels is down. Let's say we don't know what session quality is. I didn't know, by the way. When you click in, you can see all the details. You can go to the report. You can see what's the recommendation. By the way, session quality is also machine learning based. It predicts, based on a lot of signals, that your conversion rate might go down in the future. So even if you didn't notice a lot of those bounce rate a little bit, time on site, a combination of everything, before you're losing conversion rates, it can kind of let you know. And it can also give you technical issues. So room to improve loading speed of top landing page. Right? So this is something just probably technical that you can fix, save yourself money that you might not have noticed. So these are cards. Let's call it cards or alerts. It's proactive based on machine learning. It's now scaled on all of you guys' analytic accounts. And also, it's on the app. So if you download the app on Android or on iOS, I feel like a commercial, on iOS, you can also play with this. So in the meeting, your boss kind of tackles you. You can kind of look at it, and you don't have to kind of find the report. That's what I do. Okay. So let's move on a little bit. I was just told that there's like different backgrounds here in the audience, so I'll kind of optimize. Is another product on the suite that does A/B testing and multivariate testing. There's a free version of Optimize, like with Google Analytics, and there's a 360 paid version for enterprise users. And what we're doing with Optimize now is planning. This is in the planning stage, but using this machine learning stuff you saw in Analytics, predicting anomalies, etc., inside Optimize. Now, it's hard to kind of understand what that means without knowing the product, so I'll show you in the demo right now the product really quick. For that, we're going to use this really, really bad-looking test website with a really bad brand name that's called Your Trip. It's a travel company. As a marketer, let's say that we want to test if maybe taking off the price here on the main page of these deals, we might attract more clicks and maybe able to convince them to kind of, with text, et cetera, to buy the travel. Maybe they're kind of afraid of the big price here. So if we want to test something like that, we can do a simple A/B test. We used to need to involve agencies, technical people, IT, et cetera, et cetera. Why don't we do this live together right now in 2 minutes? We go into Optimize. This is Optimize. Looks amazing. Create experiment. Random name. Hopefully the internet is a little bit sluggish. Now you can see here the original, this is the version with the price that you just saw. 100% of our traffic is going to that version. Let's create another variation. We'll call it Variant 1, because I'm lazy. And now we need to create a different version, right? We click here to save the changes, to log in. Now it's going to open the website within Optimize UI. So this is like PowerPoint or Google Slides if you try that. It's super simple. You can just change now anything you like on the website, images, text, whatever. And that's it. So what do we want to do? We wanted to take away this. We right-click, we click Remove, and we take it out. Right? Oh, what did I do? It's a new laptop. Click Remove. That's it. We can click Save here. Oh, there's another one? Oh my God, London, okay. Let's do it right. Save, done, and we're done. So now we created the version without the prices, right? And now you can see 50% of our traffic goes to the original with the prices, 50% without the prices. We create an objective, doesn't matter, it's just a demo. You can do a custom objective, or I'm just gonna click whatever. Save, start experiment. Yes, start already. And you start. So about 2 minutes, you can create a very simple experiment like that. Just as an example of one of the reports that you would get, a report could look like this, one of the reports. You get a bunch of reports. It could be that this means that there's a 97% likelihood, probability, that the version that we created without the prices is going to perform better than the original. Great. How much better? It's going to perform 39% better. So in this case, if it's clicks, we're measuring 39% more clicks. Great. We switch to the new website, to the new version, and we get going. And when I talked about machine learning, we want to enterprise clients of ours don't do A/B tests like this. They do maybe 100 of those at the same time on different pages, and they do multivariate tests. So you change many things on the same page. You can do that also as well. And then there's so much information on data over there. With machine learning ability, we'll be able to probably identify like anomalies, opportunities, or problems that we really wouldn't be able to do it in the regular optimized product. So this is something, like we saw in Analytics, so this is something really cool to look forward to. Okay. Where were we? Ooh. BigQuery. Did you guys hear of a Google Cloud kind of BigQuery? Did you ever hear that kind of? This is our data warehouse, Google's data warehouse. So think of it as like a location where you can store kind of all your data and from all the sources of data that you have and use on that data machine learning, Google's machine learning analyses on that data and then take that data out somewhere else. Okay? So for example, you have your point of sale data perhaps, or you have your CRM data, or you have your third-party data, first-party data, second-party data. You take all that stuff together. You push everything to the cloud, everything to BigQuery over here, and then you can just you analyze it with machine learning, and I'll explain about that in a minute. And then you can kind of just activate on it on media or anything else that you like, the newsletter, text message, etc. So for example, if you're a travel site, I was just discussing this with someone here yesterday, but if you're a travel site and your funnel, your user funnel is so complicated, right? So if you have an analyst, he might say, and tell me if this is familiar, okay, if let's create this remarketing, this audience of those that are from this geolocation, from this demographic, from mobile, in the evening. These signals will tell, this is a good, and bounced off my shopping cart, whatever. So you use these five parameters to kind of create this audience, and you retarget it, you send a newsletter, text message, whatever you do, emails, to increase your revenue, right? So machine learning can take all that data from all those sources and identify your audiences, not based on those five criteria, but maybe 300 signals from different sources. This is how you get to this, to much, much better conversions than usual. And while you have your machine learning analyses, you want to make strategic decision based on this. You need to visualize this. You need reports. You can take that data, put it to any reporting system. My favorite is actually a Google one. You'll be surprised, which is Data Studio. So Data Studio is the reporting and visualization tool. Do people here use Data Studio? Good. It's really, first of all, it's free. There's no kind of enterprise free version. It's free for everyone. And it's such a cool product. And what I was thinking of doing is showing it to you live so you'll see how easy it is to use. This is Data Studio. You click here on a new report. Let's say you got all your machine learning analyses. Let's use our data source from the Your Trip website that we just saw. Let's push all the data here, add to report. Now, this was an international site, right? So we can kind of create a geography, a geomap over here really quick. Let's see where all the people are coming from. Let's create a pie chart here of all the, what they actually buy mostly, Paris, New York, Maldives, etc. The colors, maybe don't match. You can quickly kind of do that, make it a little bit kind of nicer. And then you can also do more complex stuff. Like, for example, we talked about audiences, right? Maybe you have like a lot of audiences and you want to show that to your CMO, and all that stuff. You can actually, like, let's say, create a time series graph over here. Right here, I have only two audiences that it pushed from analytics into Data Studio. So these are like those kind of people that buy like cheaper trips, and I'm comparing them to the people that buy more expensive trips. Let's take this, all the users off. The style here is a little bit weird. Let me see. No, what have I done? Here. So now we can see the performance between those standards, these two audiences, how they perform over time. And you can keep working on this for 10, 15 more minutes, and you get something like this. You put a background picture, a logo. You can put your different data sources inside here from your advertising activity, TV stuff, point of sale, whatever. And this is connected to your data source continuously. So this gets updated like all the time. So when you when you share this with your, this works like Google Slides, right? So you share it like this, like with your manager, for example. I don't want to share it with my manager. I hope he can kind of get upset at me. I'll share it with myself. But you can share it with your manager. He can see it on their mobile phone. It get updates all the time. He doesn't need to kind of, you don't need to do it again for him or for her. And you can just collaborate as an organization on this report with your colleagues. This is Data Studio, and there's something a little bit off topic on Data Studio, but this is really exciting for those of you who are using Data Studio. We just opened it to developers that are our partners, and what they do is develop connectors that So basically, let's say you want to connect the Facebook data into this, Twitter data, whatever, you need to write your own scripts. Sometimes you don't have the technical ability within the company, etc. These developers create these connectors for you. So it's like seamless, like I just connected the your trip, you just click on it. And you can use Facebook, or there's more than 250, and we just launched it. You know, Amazon, LinkedIn, what if you're in Russia, Yandex. But you can do all that stuff. So this is very exciting for those of you who are messing up with that. I think just kind of as a final note, I think, you know, if you're here, you obviously understand how important data is to your organization and maybe to your position within the organization, to your personal success within the organization as well. And I think it's so crazy and sexy, and all the stuff that I showed you is already happening. This is not like the future, this is happening. But it also gets a little bit complicated sometimes. So my recommendation for you guys is not to try to do everything yourselves. Even in Google, with so many things that we let other people, other companies do for us. It's not the best time to kind of work on this internally for 2 years and understand how to do it in 2 years when you have companies, partners that you can bring in to work on that for you and give you that competitive edge in your markets. That's it for me. Thank you.